Good evening and a very warm welcome to this first choral evensong of this new academic year, whether you're worshipping here with us in person or online. Especially as we celebrate harvest this Sunday at Alton's. Dearly beloved brethren, the scripture moveth us in sundry places to acknowledge and confess our manifold sins and wickedness, and that we should not dissemble nor cloak them before the face of Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, but confess them with an humble, lowly, penitent, and obedient heart, to the end that we may obtain forgiveness of the sin by his infinite goodness and mercy. And although we ought at all times humbly to acknowledge our sins before God, yet ought we most chiefly so to do, when we assemble and meet together, to render thanks for the great benefits that we have received at his hands, to set forth his most worthy praise, to hear his most holy word, and to ask those things which are requisite and necessary, as well for the body as the soul. Wherefore, I pray and beseech you, as many as are here present, to accompany me with a pure heart and humble voice unto the throne of the heavenly grace, saying after me, Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from thy ways like us. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against thy holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And there is no help in us, but thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us which offend us. Spare thou then, O God, which takes us. Restore thou then that are penitent, according to thy promises, dead and mankind. In Christ Jesus, and grant him most blessed. Be made hereafter in the body, righteous and saved alive, to the glory of thy holy name. Amen. Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who desireth not the death of a sinner, but rather that he may turn from his wickedness and live, and hath given power and commandment to his ministers, to declare and pronounce to his people, being penitent, the absolution and remission of their sins. He pardoneth and absolveth all them that truly repent and unfeignedly believe his holy gospel. Wherefore let us beseech him to grant us true repentance and his Holy Spirit, that those things may please him which we do at this present, and that the rest of our life hereafter may be pure and holy, so that at the last we may come to his eternal joy, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread.
Thank you.
sit as the choir sings Psalm 142, Standing for the Glory.
A reading from Deuteronomy, chapter 8, starting at verse 7. For the Lord your God is bringing you into a good land, a land with flowing streams, with springs and underground waters welling up in valleys and hills, a land of wheat and barley, of vines and fig trees and pomegranates, a land of olive trees and honey, a land where you may eat bread without scarcity, where you will lack nothing, a land whose stones are iron, from whose hills you may mine copper. You shall eat your fill and bless the Lord your God for the good land that he has given you. Take care that you do not forget the Lord your God by failing to keep his commandments, his ordinances, and his statutes, which I am commanding you today. When you have eaten your fill and have built fine houses and live in them, and when your herds and flocks have multiplied and your silver and gold is multiplied, and all that you have is multiplied. Then do not exalt yourself, forgetting the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery, who led you through the great and terrible wilderness, an arid wasteland with poisonous snakes and scorpions. He made water flow for you from flint rock and fed you in the wilderness with manna that your ancestors did not know, to humble you and to test you, and in the end, to do you good. Do not say to yourself, my power and the might of my own hand have gained me this wealth. But remember, the Lord your God, for it is he who gives you power to get wealth, so that he may confirm his covenant that he swore to your ancestors, as he is doing today. Here endeth the first lesson.
Thank you. The second reading is taken from Luke, chapter 12, starting at verse 16. Then he told them a parable. The land of a rich man produced abundantly, and he thought to himself, "What should I do? For I have no place to store my crops." Then he said, "I will do this. I will pull down my barns and build larger ones, and there I will store all my grain and my goods. And I will say to my soul, 'Soul, you have ample goods laid upon for many years. Relax, eat, drink, and be merry.' But God said to him, 'You fool, this very night your life is being demanded of you, and the things you have prepared, whose will they be?' So it is with those who store up treasures for themselves, but are not rich towards God." He said to his disciples, "Therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat, or about your body, what you will wear. For life is more than food, and the body more than clothing. Consider the ravens. They neither sow nor reap. They have neither storehouse nor barn, and yet God feeds them. Of how much more value are you than the birds? And can any of you be worrying at a single hour to your span of life? If then you are not able to do so small a thing as that, why do you worry about the rest? Consider the lilies, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin. Yet I tell you, even Solomon in all his glory was not clothed like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass of the field, which is alive today and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, how much more will he clothe you, you of little faith? And do not keep striving for what you are to eat and what you are to drink, and do not keep worrying, for it is the nations of the world that strive after all these things, and your Father knows that you need them." Here endeth the second lesson.
that we may know your saving love in our streets, in our workplaces, and in our homes, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Say together, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost, be with us all evermore. Amen. We are seated as the choir sings the anthem, Sorrow Antiphon, by William Mann.
Thank you.
Let us pray. On this harvest Thanksgiving, we give thanks for all who work the land and the sea. God our Father, you never cease the work you have begun, and prosper with your blessing all human labour. Make us wise and faithful stewards of your gifts, that we may serve the common good, maintain the fabric of our world, and seek that justice where all may share the good things you pour upon us. This we ask through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And we pray for your church, for this patch of holy ground, and for all who work and worship here, for all that will happen in this place in this coming week, for all who will visit, for those who will come for private prayer, those who will come for worship. Heavenly Father, you have called us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ, to continue his work of reconciliation and reveal you to the world. Give us the courage to overcome our fears and to seek that unity which is your gift and your will. This we ask through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And we continue to pray for the peace of your world, for Ukraine, for all places, conflict, oppression, or persecution. We pray for all who seek to bring about or maintain peace. Almighty God, from whom all thoughts of truth and peace proceed, kindle, we pray, in the hearts of all the true love of peace, and guide with your pure and peaceable wisdom all who take counsel for the nations of the earth, that in tranquility your kingdom may go forward, till the earth is filled with the knowledge of your name. This we ask through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And in a moment of silence, offer our own prayers to you, remembering those who are sick, those who are on our own hearts at this time. Almighty God, you have said that what we ask in your name we may receive in faith. Receive these our prayers this night. Be with us in the coming hours and bring us safe to the start of a new day. This we pray in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our risen and glorified Lord. Amen.
There are a number of notices to announce this evening, the first of which is to say thank you very much to Father David, who baked that wonderful loaf at the altar. Only kidding, Stenning's Bakery baked it. but please do take some of it away with you after the service if you fancy some bread. So I'm not quite sure how we're going to do that, but we'll make it work and probably just tear it apart. So that's the first harvest notice. Services are as normal this week, with morning prayer and evening prayer at the same time, morning prayer at 8:30 a.m. and evening prayer at 5:30 p.m. With Mass on Tuesday at 10 a.m, Wednesday at 5:30 p.m. and Thursday at 10 a.m. The Sunday services next week are back to normal, with an all-age Mass at 9 a.m. and High Mass at 10:30 a.m. and sung evening prayer at 6:30 p.m. Please do have a look on the table over there for a piece of paper that says please sign up. an A4 piece of paper that says, please sign up. Please do fill this out. It asks for your contact details. So when Queen Elizabeth II passed away, it became kind of obvious to us that sometimes we need to change services at very short notice. So it would be fantastic if we have an up-to-date record of everyone's details so that we can quickly email you to let you know if there's going to be a change, and also just to keep in touch with you as well. So please do fill out the please sign up A4 piece of paper on the table over there. Coming up, Carshalton Opera will be doing several performances of Carmen. So on Saturday the 15th of October at 7 p.m. and Sunday the 16th of October at 3 p.m. The Sunday one is suitable for children. That's all here in church. Tickets can be bought in advance from the Carshalton Opera website, but I think you can also buy tickets on the door. So please do come and support Carshalton Opera and the church by coming to those on the 15th and 16th of October. On Saturday the 22nd of October at 7 p.m, there'll be a jazz version of West Side Story. And I think there's going to be beer served at that as well, so that's quite exciting. Tickets are £15. You can book the tickets off of our website. Once again, you can also buy tickets on the door. Another event coming up on Tuesday the 18th of October, I hope everyone's making notes, at 7:30 p.m, Tuesday the 18th of October, is a lecture here in church on Sir William Scawen, or Scawen. I've heard people in Carshalton pronounce it differently each time I hear it. So Sir William Scawen was one of the founding members of the Bank of England and was a Carshaltonite through and through. So please do come and listen to a lecture about him in front of his memorial over there, Tuesday the 18th of October. Tickets are £5, and the lecture will be given by local historian Andrew Skelton. In terms of other notices, after the passing of Queen Elizabeth II, it's been suggested that we buy something or do something to remember her more physically and more permanently. So please do speak to Father David and I if you have any ideas as to what that might be, whether it be a processional cross, a stained glass window, and whether you'd be willing to contribute towards something we can get to remember the late her late Majesty. Also, if you're into flower arranging, on Friday the 21st of October at 6:30 p.m, there will be a flower arranging workshop with kind of the environment and sustainability in mind. So please do put that in your diary if you are interested in learning more about flower arranging. We're really blessed here at All Saints to have some excellent flower arrangers who work very hard week in, week out to provide excellent floral displays. Those are all the notices for this evening, and thank you for bearing with me on that. So we stand for the dismissal.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us bless the Lord.